Now is the time for doing some meditation. So, meditation is, as you have done any meditation before, is not to be looked upon as something difficult. Looked upon as relaxation, learning how to do nothing, learning how to chill out, learning how just to be. So please do not regard meditation as another thing which you have to learn, develop, another thing you have to try and achieve, where you always feel you're a failure again if you don't get somewhere. Meditation is not about getting somewhere, it's about being here. It's not about wanting something more, it's about being content with what you have and where you are. It's about learning how to make peace with this moment. So open the door of your heart to what you're experiencing right now, to be very gentle, which also includes patience. Patience is not waiting for something to happen. Patience is waiting in this moment. So, such an easy thing to do, so please don't make it complicated. So I will give the instructions like guided meditation for the first 20 minutes, and then I'll be quiet for a little while, and then after the quiet time is completed, then there's the opportunity, I'll just wrap up the meditation and then afterwards start the talk. So first of all, just please go nice. Very good. Okay, so here we go on our little guided meditation for half an hour. It might not be what you heard before, but if it was what you heard before, you wouldn't be learning anything new. So every time you teach a meditation this way or that way, get another angle on the meditation process, and you put them all together, and you find underneath all the types of meditation, there's a common theme of letting things be, relaxing, learning how to make, or allow the mind to be still. So, we start off by closing our eyes. And with the eyes closed, first of all, make sure all your mobile phones are turned off. If your mobile devices go off just when someone's about to get enlightened this afternoon, your mobile device makes such bad karma. In its next life, it will be reincarnated as a parking meter, which is the lowest form of life next to speed cameras for electronic high-tech equipment. So please, out of compassion for your iPhones or tablets, whatever you have, please turn them off. So, now see if you can turn off your wandering mind as well. Put it into not flight mode, but meditation mode. The whole purpose of the next half an hour is learning how to relax, to make peace, to be free. So we start by looking at our body, our posture. There is no magic position for your body which is the best for every meditation. In fact, you find out in every meditation what is the best position for you. And you adopt that position with awareness and kindness. So you start with your legs, just a little bit of carefulness with how your body is positioned. Don't need to open the eyes, but how do your legs feel right now? From your toes to your thighs. And feel quite free to move them, to find the best position for them. First of all, you may not be in the most comfortable position, so you move them, adjust them. Just like when you are looking through a telescope, you have to adjust the lens to focus it, to get it just right. So you're aware, you move, you're aware, until you get the feedback which comes from mindfulness, to get the best possible position for your body. That's mindfulness, together with kindness. And once you feel that your legs are in the best possible position, you can leave them alone. And then you bring your awareness up to your bottom, your buttocks, pressed against the chair, seat. How do they feel? Do you need to wriggle, to fidget that bottom, to try and get it more comfortable? If you need to, please do so. And once you've adjusted the position, you're mindful again, is this more comfortable? The mindfulness gives you feedback so you can adjust more until you find the optimum position. Sometimes people who are not meticulous in adjusting their posture get aches and pains which disturb the meditation later on. So once the bottom is well adjusted, then you're aware of your back. It does not always need to be straight. It can be leaning back. And in fact, for most people, the most comfortable, healthy position for the back is leaning at 15 degrees to the vertical, which is the almost exact angle of the backrest of your chair. The reason why chairs have that backrest leaning backwards at that angle is just the evolution of furniture. These are the ones which work, which become most popular, which sell. So it's quite okay if you wish to lean back in the chair. But if you find it more comfortable leaning forward, fine, it's up to you. So through trial and error, through adjustment, always mindful, aware of those feelings, and not stopping the movement until the feedback from mindfulness indicates this is the best possible position at this time for you. And then you look at the position of your hands. You feel it. Many people fidget their hands. They do it so often they think it's normal, but it's irritating, disturbing if you're trying to be still in meditation. So see if you can get your hands in the best possible position to begin with. They don't have to be on the knee or in your lap. Wherever your hands can feel comfortable, that is where you put them. And to know the best position, again, you're aware of the feelings in your hands. And as you move, you see which position is the best for you right now. Once you find that best position, you leave it there. Such a simple method, but highly effective in relaxing your body. Then you move your awareness up to your shoulders, which is a seat of great tension for many people. And in order to relax those shoulders, just telling them to relax often doesn't work. So instead you can imagine your shoulders them consisting of many, many bundles of string which have been stretched like elastic, pulled on both ends until it's stressed. You can imagine that, visualize the muscles in your shoulders have been pulled on both ends. And then you imagine, you visualize, letting go of both ends, releasing the pulling, the stretching, so the muscles can relax, can become loose, not pulled, not stretched, not squashed, but let go of, so they can relax into a natural, comfortable state. And after the muscles in the shoulders have been relaxed, can you feel them? Can the feedback of mindfulness indicate you are actually relaxing something? Your shoulders are getting more peaceful, more comfortable. It's just a job of awareness and kindness. Awareness checks you're going in the correct direction of relaxation. You'll find that what does relax your body is this beautiful kindness, opening the door of your heart in this moment. And then you can move your attention up from your shoulders to your throat. If you've got an itchy throat, it's quite all right to cough. If you try to stop the coughing, it usually gets worse. If you allow yourself to cough whenever you need to, you'll find that you'll cough less. The mindfulness will show you that controlling makes irritations worse. Open the door of your heart and letting it be makes them less. At the same time, you're relaxing what could be an irritating neck or throat. Then you move your attention up to your head. To be able to relax the head to find its best position, sometimes you can experiment moving the head left, right, forward, back, until you notice which is the best position for your head upon your neck. And I also encourage to be aware of the muscles around the eyes, how tense or how loose they are. Once you're mindful of that feeling around your eyes, it becomes quite simple to relax those muscles, to loosen the tightness and tension. The reason why the muscles around the eyes can be important, because fear, desire, many emotions change the tone of the muscles around the eyes. And so by relaxing those muscles, you're relaxing the longing or the fear. And it feels good when the muscles in the face and the whole rest of the body have been dealt with one by one. Relax as much as you can. Then you find the body feels at ease. It feels comfortable. Sometimes it even tingles with what I call the delight of a body that's been relaxed part by part. At the same time, you're redeveloping awareness, otherwise known as mindfulness, together with kindness. The two qualities which really are essential on the path of meditation. Mindfulness and kindness. And then once the body is what you think is relaxed, then just check your body again. There may be just one part of the body inside. It might be your lungs or your heart or your bowels or some other ache or pain somewhere inside of the body which doesn't get less by moving because it's deep inside. A wound, an injury, a disease. So as you look at the body, see if you can notice the most irritating or painful part of your body and focus in on it, zoom in on it. And once you have awareness of an irritating part of your own body, then you can try kindness. The awareness of that pain again gives you the feedback. So you can see if the pain or the irritation, the ache, gets less or gets more. If the irritation gets more, you've obviously been going in the wrong direction. If the irritation gets less, if the pain is alleviated, you're going in the correct direction. Carry on. And this is how we learn. We know it's the right way because mindfulness tells us it's getting better. And with this little training, you find you can take any part of the body which is aching, which is in pain, which is unbalanced, and you can relax it totally away, thereby healing many painful injuries or even diseases. Mindfulness and kindness working together to relax the body and allow it to heal. And once the body feels good, relax as much as you can. Then let it go. And move your attention, your mindfulness, to your emotional world, to your mind. And ask yourself a simple question. Am I peaceful or am I agitated? Give it a number from 1 to 10. 5 is average, 1 is really peaceful, 10 is very agitated. Give yourself an honest number. The only reason I ask this is because when you are looking at how peaceful or how agitated you feel, it is becoming mindful of what I call the peaceometer. Just like you have a speedometer on the car which tells you how fast you're going, or a thermometer in the room to say whether it's hot or whether it's cold. Once you have the peaceometer in your mindfulness's view, you know how peaceful or how agitated you are. Then the next step is to, what do I need to do to be able to move that needle of my own peaceometer closer to 1? What makes me more peaceful? What makes me more agitated? Again, mindfulness gives you the feedback. And if your mind becomes more peaceful, you usually find it's because you're not trying to force it, control it, strive for something. That just makes you more agitated. But instead you're being content and kind, opening the door of your heart to this moment, no matter what it is, making peace with it, being kind and being gentle. That, you will find, makes even your mind become more and more peaceful. You'll also find that when you start thinking about the past, worrying about the future, that needle goes up, gets more agitated. But when you just rest in the present moment, accepting this moment, you'll find you become more and more peaceful. And you can feel that peace. Because this is what you're aware of, the peace of it. And throughout the meditation, always be aware of how peaceful you are growing, or how agitated you are becoming. So it's a check to make sure you're on the correct path. Meditation has nothing to do with agitation. The stillness is peace. So in order to develop that peace, we watch and mindful of the peaceometer and how we bring that needle closer and closer to 1. as you are aware of peace, get more and more calm. You may become aware of your breathing, breath coming in, breath going out, but don't force awareness on the breath. If you go looking for the breath and focusing on the breathing, you will find that the peaceometer goes closer up to 10. You're disturbing, agitating the mind. So instead, just allow the breath to come in. Let the breath go out. Your job is not to do the breathing, nor to tell the breathing how to go in, how to go out. Your job is to calmly watch as the breath goes in and out. And to make it more interesting, as you breathe in, imagine you're breathing in energy, health, freedom, with every in-breath. As you breathe out, imagine breathing out any toxins, any ill health, any past or future, any negativity. Breathing out, we let go of all that's troublesome and negative. As we breathe in energy, health, peace. Breathing in, peace. Breathe out, let go. Breathing in, peace. Breathe out, let go. Breathing in peace. Breathe out, let go. I'm now going to be quiet for a few minutes. I start speaking again, we'll be closer to the meditation. Ending. do you feel? Do not open your eyes yet. Just check on how relaxed is your body and how peaceful is your mind. And also, why? Find out the causes, the reasons why the body is relaxed. Find out the reason what makes the mind still. And see if you can be aware of the quality of such a peaceful mind. It is like a lake in the mountains. When it has ripples or waves on the surface, you cannot see a perfect reflection of the moon and the stars in the sky above. The waves, the ripples, the agitation distorts the reflection. But when the lake is perfectly still, only then is the reflection accurate and true. Now I invite you to count three more breaths. In, out, in, out, in, out. At the end of the third out breath, you may open your eyes to end the meditation after three more breaths.